You know just where to stop, Thomas, laughed his driver. You could almost manage it without me. Thomas had become conceited. He didn't realize his driver was joking. Later, he boasted to the other. Driver says I don't need him now. Don't be so daft, snorted Percy. I'd never go without my driver, said Toby earnestly. I'd be frightened. Huh, boasted Thomas. I'm not scared. You'd never dare. I would then. You'll see. The next morning, the firelighter came, housed comfortably as the warmth spread through his boiler. Percy and Toby were still asleep. Thomas suddenly remembered. Silly stick in the muds, he chuckled. I'll show them. Driver said I could manage without him. I'll just go out and then I'll stop and whee! That'll make them jump. Thomas thought he was being clever. He was open moving because the careless cleaner had meddled with control. Soon found his mistake. He tried to whee! He tried to stop, but he couldn't. Just kept rolling along. He didn't dare look at what was coming next. There was the station master now. Countess. The station master was about to have breakfast. Plaster was everywhere. Thomas had collected a bush on his travels. He peered into the room through its leaves. He couldn't speak. The station master was furious. His wife picked up her plate. You miserable engine, she scolded. Just look what you've done to our breakfast. She'll have to cook some more. She banged the door. More plaster fell. This time it fell on Thomas. Thomas felt depressed.
Workmen propped up the house with strong poles and laid rails through the garden. Then, the Spanish twin engines...
Thank you.